For one Hooksett neighborhood, it was news they couldn't believe.
It's not right. It's not right. I'm outraged. I am outraged.
A registered sex offender, Joel Dutton, arrested for allegedly reoffending, then being allowed to go home on what's called personal recognizance bail, basically a promise you'll return to court and follow the rules.
It's shocking to me that he got let out. Yeah, I mean, the system doesn't do enough.
Dutton remains free on that bail. Understanding the bail system can be difficult. Just look at some recent cases, the allegations and their bail amounts. A college student accused of phone threats, held on $25,000 cash bail. His case is on hold as he undergoes hospital treatment. A man accused of assaulting a 2-year-old in West Stewartstown released on that PR bail, meaning no cash exchange, just a promise to return to court. He was later sent to jail, his bail revoked after police say he violated the terms of release. And a Hooksett man accused of burglary, bail $50,000 cash. His case is now moving forward in the court system.
Feels wrong. It doesn't seem fair. But it's because one doesn't understand what the purpose of bail is.
Setting bail in each case is actually very subjective because there are no set rules in New Hampshire. And it is often a bail commissioner, like Steve Dembo, who set the original bail.
The bail has to be reasonable and appropriate.
Because New Hampshire doesn't have night court or weekend sessions, Dembo acts as the judge when it comes to bail. He can get called into the lockup at Merrimack Police Department at any hour of the day.
Sometimes it gets very nasty. Sometimes it's jovial.
For a $40 fee, he'll set a temporary bail until a suspect can go to court. In the cases we looked at, the judge often agreed with that original bail. Dembo looks at a suspect's history, family life, and employment to determine how much bail should be and what restrictions should be set.
Does this person go home? Does this person have to go to jail? Does this person have to come up with some money in order to gain release?
Suspects can get a few different kinds of bail. Personal recognizance, or PR, the one mentioned earlier, meaning you go home and if you don't show up at court, you have to pay the bail amount. Cash bail, meaning you have to pay cash to get out. Or corporate surety, meaning you pay a bail bondsman about a 10% fee who guarantees the bail amount getting you out. So which suspects get which?
It depends on the circumstances of each of those people.
There are two main objectives in setting bail. Will this person return to court for their arraignment? And is this person a danger to themselves or someone else? For example, if a local resident got a first-time DUI offense, they'll likely be released on PR bail. But if a suspect might harm someone or has jumped bail before, bail will likely be a high cash amount.
If the person is, you know, charged in Manchester and is from Manchester, there's probably a lesser risk that the person won't show up than if the person is from Wyoming.
With the exception of major crimes like murder, bail amounts vary widely, and for a reason. When Joel Dutton was released, police say he had no failures to appear, lived locally, and was no longer living near the alleged victim. He did return weeks later for his next court appearance, and his bail went unchanged. But when this burglary suspect was held on $50,000 cash bail, it was because he had previous failures to appear, no local ties, and a criminal history. Experts say it's important to remember bail is about getting suspects back to court, not about punishment.
If you're thinking about we want to punish this guy before he goes to trial for what he did, you're finding him guilty before he's had a trial.
New Hampshire doesn't keep stats on who shows up and who jumps bail. The head of the Superior Court says suspects do fail to appear, but so far it hasn't been widespread.
My sense is that there is not, for lack of a better term, an epidemic of people not appearing.
In case you're wondering, not counting fees, you do get your bail money back at the end of the case if you show up when you're supposed to. I'm Sean McDonald, WMUR News 9.